Thank you. be playing here tonight. Thank you all for coming out. Huge, huge, huge thanks to Mr. Nick. Check, check. For picking this. What's your last, dude? I don't know your last name.
Acosta,
okay. Not to be confused with Sean Costa. Is everyone doing all right tonight? How about this? Anyone feeling like shit tonight? Yeah, we gotta start asking that a little more often. Maybe normalized feeling like shit is about due. This idea, every day I talk to my students and, you know, it's quick. It's like a fucking factory sometimes in a high school setting. But, goddamn, you just walk in and you just say, how you doing? They're like, yeah, fun. I hate that. I fucking hate the in and out situation we've created ourselves here in this modern, so-called modern era with all this wonderful technology to bring us together. And every year I'm just sensing a little greater sense of distance despite the fact that we're supposed to be easier and greater and easier communication. This next song is about a friendship that began in a time before social media, in a time in which boredom prompted you not to pick up your phone, but to go outside and experience life with someone else in the beautiful October and November Massachusetts sky. This one's for Ryan Udon, the Eternal, and my lovely wife. Go! could sing. And it's always been a very wonderful, awesome privilege to have people sing along and help me not have to sing. I especially want to thank all the young people who came to see us at Wisconsin. Fuck yeah. They're here! Yo, I've been playing shows for like 20 fucking years. That shit hits still. People coming out, support, you see them again. Peace and love, this song is to you. And you, cause you're all gonna deal with some fucking death! It's hard to relate when you're on your own. It's hard to relate when you're doing wrong. It's hard to relate when the days are long. And the one you know is forever gone. It's hard to relate, hard to come out! Come out! Come out! meditation. I was raised Catholic. I couldn't personally hear what I was hoping for. And I'll spend my life trying to figure out somehow the reason that we're here and then we're not.
Music!
about what I know, and what I know lately in the last decade of my life is teenage pressure. I see it, and I hate it. It's, to me, it's the essence of what I think makes us beautiful, to be young and free, not just because of your age, but because of your mentality. And there's something about the most precious system, the education system, that sadly has this thing of making people feel fucking small, stupid, and not worthy, which is why I became a teacher, to push back against those forces, not to sit on the sidelines and say, school sucks. I'm in the fucking field saying that it sucks, but that it can be better. To all the people who just did their early action applications, who are looking down a semester, feeling like shit, this one's for you. And everyone else who's been let down! Started, the intention was to never play live. Truly, the deal was to write as if no one will ever hear it, which felt liberating, but simultaneously stupid. We like to play in dark blue lights, at least I do. We don't have that option. I don't like to sing this song out in the open, but the fucking meaning of the song is about putting yourself in the open. So anybody who's on that edge, worried about what your hardcore peers or your asshole friends who aren't really friends think of you, this song's a nice, gentle fuck you. Yeah.
so rich. Yeah, my voice is calling out to ya. Up in the moonlight, cold and blue. I'll be the solid brick, grow and grow and grow. You can find me in the other trash. I'll be the sound of shaking leg. Fall off from the green, the black, the black, the black. God! Yeah!
Thank you.
That's it, folks. Peace and love. Hopefully, we'll be back.